Hi guys, welcome to TISnet podcast video, and today we have Gaurang Joshi. He is from Kolhapur, Maharashtra, and he got selected for TIS Tuljapur campus, right? He scored 51 marks and MA in Social Innovation and Entrepreneurship. This is what the program he got selected in Tuljapur campus. So let's talk to Gaurang and understand his preparation strategy, what are the obstacles he came across, and why TISS. This is what the very common sort of a question ki TIS kyun chahiye, and obviously why this program basically. So to those who are planning to go for the same program, so I think in this video you will understand from Gaurang. He will guide you with regards to his preparation and the program, and then many other questions also will be asking. So hi Gaurang.
Hello. Hello Dev sir.
How are you?
I'm very well, thank you. How about you sir?
I'm also good and feeling very great that you got the TISS campus.
Yes, thank you yes. So much, thanks for having me today.
Yeah. Okay, great. So just tell me about yourself, what you academic wise or a qualification wise, and what is your goal in the TIS campus?
Okay, so I'm basically from Kolhapur, Maharashtra, small city in western Maharashtra.
Right.
And it's basically flourish with agricultural sector, has rural based economy. I always have in my mind, you know, to thrive in this agricultural or, you know, rural based kind of business activity or any sort of that kind of venture. If I would get into, then, you know, it would be service to the community as well. After my graduation, I was also thinking, what should I pursue as a course wise, and I chose, you know, to become chartered accountant, but that was kind of not cup of my tea, so I just changed my strategy, and I just gave, you know, CAT, SAT, and all those MBA entrance exam to pursue career in MBA.
Okay.
So after giving those entrance examination, I just got selected for IIMT Nagpur, and I finished my MBA from there. Okay. I was kind of a bit disappointed because I need to get into much more better colleges. But again, my preparation or the lack of, you know, strategy happened, so that's the reason I couldn't get into the much more like elite colleges. I was introduced with the Baha'i community in my town. They actually teach about Baha'i faith and moral and spiritual education.
Okay.
Community.
So when this idea came in your mind regarding the TISS?
Like, I just want to brief a little bit that, so through that Baha'i faith, I went to Israel for the service.
Okay.
Yeah. So last 4 years I was in Israel, and I just came during like last September. Like, you know, in Baha'i faith, it is always taught that you need to engage into community-based services. So the service you do for your community or for the people or to your nation, mm-hmm. is as equivalent to the service to the worshiping God.
Okay.
That's the main principle of Baha'i faith.
Okay.
And I always have in my mind that to pursue, you know, a profession or have occupation which is service oriented, but I need that solid and strong platform. So I was, you know, researching about it, and I just came to know about like TIS. TIS is the best institution for the social services. So if I want to pursue career in like service related occupation, so I need to study or, you know, understand better about that field. And that's how I just applied for the TIS. And for the TIS, you have to prepare for the TISnet. And TISnet is, you know, as compared to CAT and SAT level, TIS is kind of, it's a different. I mean, you required English, you required to study mathematics, but, you know, up to the basic levels. For example, if you are good at maths, like up to 10 to 12 kind of level, then you probably have that advantage. But okay. also the one vital part about TISnet is general knowledge. That can be,
game changer.
Make or break, game changer.
Right.
And so maybe if you are good at English or maybe if you are have that advantage of mathematics, but if you are weak at general knowledge, then that can be, disadvantage to you and vice versa.
Yes. Basically, Gaurang is explaining about his preparation strategy, but Gaurang, it's a very long journey that why you started your TISnet preparation. I mean, it's a very good journey. I mean, very long journey that you, I mean, this you came from Israel, then you research. Before that, in Kolhapur, you have the one which you have mentioned, the social work which you have mentioned. So it's a very long journey, very high. I haven't met such people. This is the first time I think I'm meeting, I mean, people like you who have this kind of thought process, basically. So when this, you have mentioned this, okay, this is the time you have to start with the TISS preparation. Okay. How you got to know about, a maneuver when you join your live class and preparation strategy? This is what the two questions.
So I think it's the time of in the month of December, I just checked the syllabus. I just knew the pattern about the TISnet that you have 40 marks of GK, 30 marks for mathematics and 30 marks for English. You need to prepare thoroughly.
Yeah, basically but, conceptual, your concept has to be thorough.
Yeah. If you have that basic concepts, then it's a win-win situation.
Correct.
Well, I'm also talking about English, my English from childhood, English was my weakness. Like English was never my friend throughout, school life.
Okay.
But I thought maybe a GK, if I strengthen my GK, that probably can have advantage over the others, because for GK you have static GK, current affairs, business affairs, sports, entertainment, media and culture, everything.
Okay.
So studying of GK is swimming into the ocean. Mm-hmm. You have to gather a lot of information and you have to read a lot of books. You need to search on internet, Google, and also on YouTube. I just came to know about Maneuver, their lectures, online lectures, and especially the mock test. The mock tests were very, very useful and very, very effective, I would say.
We had launched 25 mock tests.
Yeah, exactly. There were 25 mock tests, and they have variety of questions, variety of static GK questions. That really that helped me a lot, especially.
Okay.
Cool. And that's, I would say, the thank you for Maneuver, that because of mock tests, I could, half credit goes to you guys. That,
okay. Thanks. Thanks for mentioning this. And let me add on here that I keep on saying, many people write their mock tests after completion of their syllabus. But what I always suggest, along with your preparation, keep on writing at least one mock test. It's
absolutely
okay, because you have 25 mock tests in your hand.
Yeah. So basically, TISnet happens very late. So you have that advantage that you already studied about the mathematics and English and, logical reasoning. So you just have to brush up your skill, and Maneuver gives that opportunity, to attend those mock tests. So 25 mock tests is more than enough, I would say. Maneuver has a very qualitative mock test, and they have a very qualitative study material, I would say. And that really helped me.
Okay. So what was your daily routine in terms of the preparation? Like, you have to prepare English, GK, and the maths is there, then your logical part. How have you divided your preparation part, basically?
Well, I had decided that I should study every day. So it's not like I'm just studying 5 to 6 hours one day and next 2 days I'm just resting. It's not, that's the bad strategy, I would say.
Okay.
Rather, you should divide at least 2 to 3 hours of study each and every day. and try. I was giving at least 1 to 2 hours for GK.
So coming back to the mock test again, you have appeared a couple of mock tests, right? Many mock tests, in fact. So what was your highest score in the mock test?
Well, my scores used to vary, you know, between 50 to 70. Okay. So initially, I
20 marks
get...
gap.
Yeah, but you know, that moment when I used to give more and more mock tests, that really built up my confidence.
Right. So your score also 51 marks. Your score in the mock was 50 to 70. 51 is the score. This is what the score you got.
Yeah. One thing I would like to mention that those who are enrolling for Manuver mock test, TISNET is kind of, you know, the difficulty level is kind of equivalent, I would say. At most of the GK question, you need to focus on current update.
I mean, have you expected, Gaurang, that you will be surely getting TISS campus, Tuljapur, Mumbai? Aisa laga tha ki milega campus?
Well, when I appeared for the exam, I thought it was kind of doable thing. Like, at least you need to be shortlisted for at least one course or one campus.
Right.
Yeah, okay. It was my, unfortunately, I missed Mumbai campus. But when I was applying, I thought maybe if anything happens, I should put another campus for the test. So Tuzapur has that kind of the cutoffs were minimum, as compared to Mumbai.
Right.
So I just have that one kind of option as a backup. So otherwise, if I got those two marks, then I would have
two marks in Mumbai campus.
Mumbai campus, yes.
Okay, Gaurang. Coming to the last question, what tips or the suggestion you want to give to all the upcoming year aspirant, those who are planning for TISS 2022, 23, 24 upcoming years? So what tips you want to give?
Well, I would say that if you are good at GK, I would say that go for TISS and you can definitely crack TISS. Be wise while choosing the courses.
Okay.
Read before, about those courses and the campuses. So you won't do mistake like me, because there was one another program from Mumbai campus itself, which I could apply, then I could have get shortlisted for that program.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I would just say that just brush up your basic skills about English and mathematics, and just read the daily newspaper. That would really helpful. And try to just watch documentaries about the Indian history and world history
for GK basically. So basically what if I summarize whole conversation, so first thing, you need to be a little bit alert about when you choose the courses basically and campuses. True. Second is nothing but
you
should stick to the, if you are preparing for the GK is like a C. So multiple resources you have to follow, and basic and the theory conceptual part of the mathematics, English and newspaper reading is very, very vital. That is what you have to take care of. And the mock test to apne ko continue likhte hain. This is what the basic preparation part one need to do if really want to crack this net exam. So that's it from Gaurang. And anything else, Gaurang, you want to add?
No. I have,
You have done with. Okay, so that's all from Gaurang and guys. And we keep on coming up with the more podcasts regarding the TISS. Many selection happened this year. So sabko leke videos aane wale. So we'll meet you in the next podcast. Bye-bye and take care.
Thank you so much.